Como é que é, pessoal? Bem-vindos novamente à Underground's Voice. Hoje o meu convidado dispensa apresentações, Paul Speckman, dos Master.
Hello, how are you?
Thank you so much for coming. It's a huge pleasure for me to meet you finally, some years later, but yeah.
Better late than never.
That's true.
Nice to meet you too. We can shake on that. Camera. Oh yeah.
Well, Master is one of the first death metal American bands ever. Actually, death metal is a way popular genre, style, and but not right now.
Thank you. Good.
But I think you, Master, is the only one or one that keeps the underground spirit alive. What do you have to say about that?
Let's just say that going back to what you first said, which is important. When Deathstrike and Master began, Possessed, Death, all around the same time, there was no such thing as death metal. We were just playing metal. Obviously, Possessed wrote a song called Death Metal. I happen to think that maybe that's where it came from. But in the early days, there were no genres, subgenres, etc., etc. It was just one genre, metal. And yes, we're keeping the spirit alive because, in my opinion, there's no reason to change anything. Okay, people are saying, oh, Speckman's still writing the same songs, you know, 30 years ago. Well, you know what? It's still effective, still heavy. I still like playing this style of music.
And it's still good.
I'm not going to jump on some trend, you know. There's a lot of these bands from the old genre that tried different trends, you know, industrial, new metal or whatever. Then they go back to it. You know, stick to your guns and do what you do best. Lemmy never changed. Hey.
Yeah. That's why you're Lemmy Kilmister of the that metal or the metal, right?
Well, that's what they say. It's a compliment, though. Rest in peace, brother.
Yeah. Back in that days when Master was created, long time ago.
Yeah.
Well, no social media, no Facebook.
Cassettes.
It was difficult for everyone to know Master, to discover the band.
It was handwritten letters. Mm-hmm. You know, like Kerrang magazine, these different magazines, they had like these pen pal sections. And what we did is we send out tapes to these people, cassettes.
Yeah.
And before you know it, they start circulating around the world. You know, thousands and thousands of bootleg copies from that original cassette, which probably sounded terrible, I'm sure, some of them. But it's still, that's how the music spread. It was from writing each other. It wasn't uncommon for guys like Chris Reifert to write me, you know, a letter or whatever, call me on the phone. And it was different back in that time. No social media. It was much more difficult. But we, you know, we persevered and fought through all of these bands.
How was the first reactions to Master back in that days with a really different sound of the band?
You know, the critics hated it. They didn't understand it.
What?
That there was a magazine back in the day called Kick-Ass Monthly, and they said the Master demo was nothing but a Slayer ripoff. That was the review. Wow. The first one, you know. Wow. I smiled about it. It doesn't matter. I love Slayer. You know, that's not the point. I didn't really hear it, you know. I thought we were doing our own thing, you know. It was a little more aggressive in its own way, you know. But anyway, doesn't matter.
Well,
go ahead.
Master is here in a lot of years, a lot of album released, thousands of shows everywhere around the world.
Yeah.
What's left to do for Master?
New album in December 15th, we begin recording.
Cool.
And we'll record for a couple of days and then we're going to go to South America and do another tour. Probably just, I think it's 20 shows in Brazil. Then we'll come back, listen to the album again, see if we still like it. If not, make a few changes in the mixes.
Yeah.
And then, obviously, it'll come out in the spring next year.
Cool.
That's the plan. And more tours, and more tours.
More tours.
You know.
Well, you're a living legend.
Well, I'm just Paul, but go ahead.
Yeah. You're still a living legend.
Okay.
And for me, one of the most important guys of the history of the underground scene, really. But I think Master was never truly recognized. Do you think
we made mistakes? We got a deal from Combat in, let's get this right here, 1985. Wow. And actually, Possessed and Death got the same contract.
Oh, yeah.
These contracts were $1,000 to record your record. It really wasn't much. Now, the point is, we made a big mistake because you know. I met this guy, Kim Fowley. He was the manager of the Runaways, and he wrote songs for Kiss and Alice Cooper, and
yeah.
He read my contract, charged me $1 a minute, which was, you know, whatever, a couple hundred dollars. That's not the point, but he turned it into a multi-million dollar contract. Oh. And at this time, this style was just beginning, you know? Nobody knew what it was.
Yeah.
So obviously Combat saw that contract, the rewritten one, and threw it in the garbage. And then it took me till 1989 to find a new deal with a Nuclear Blast, and that's what happened. We got lost in the shuffle. Then all these bands started signing, having success, and Master disappeared, I guess, for a few years, until Mitch Harris from Napalm Death originally,
yeah.
And Righteous Pigs, and the singer too, what's his name? I can't remember right now. I haven't talked to him in a long time, but I met the singer from Righteous Pigs in the woods. I was drinking some beer after moving furniture. At that time, I was a mover, and I gave him the Abomination demo.
Yep.
And he had talked about this label, Nuclear Blast, that Righteous Pigs had just signed to, and he sent him the demo. And the next thing I know, we had an Abomination contract, followed by a Master contract, and the rest is history in some ways, you're going to say. That's why I'm still here today. Sorry about that, Joe, by the way. Joe Caper was a big help for my career. I'm a little tired of Joe after 18 shows. You got to understand that you don't tour. You're at home watching TV right now.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Well,
just in case he sees it. Yeah. He's like that asshole.
Probably
you know?
Not, but yeah.
That asshole. He doesn't remember my name anymore. I'm tired. Okay, go ahead.
Well, Master, been in Portugal a couple of times.
Yeah.
Do you have any opinion about the Portuguese crowd? Any good memories about the gigs here?
The Barcelos Metal Fest was a blast. Hard Metal Festival some years ago.
Yeah.
Or this Christmas Festival. I forgot what it was called.
Oh.
Butchery for Christmas or something. Yeah. Excellent as well. We had a lot of really nice experiences here in Portugal.
And yesterday in Lisbon.
Yesterday in Lisbon, RCA, excellent. 96 Maniacs. Wonderful sound. We're happy to be here in Porto as well.
Okay. It will be cool too. First time I will see Master finally.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to play the first album tonight for you.
Yeah.
Mostly.
Just for me. Well, any other something new we can expect about the new album?
No, it's back to the roots, old school. Also, I have the number 4 album with Johannes Beckman will be coming out in 3 months.
Yeah.
Just finished the recordings for number 4.
Cool.
It's the best one of the 4, anyway. So look for that. That's pretty much what's going on. Any more questions?
Well, finally, last words for the Portuguese fans.
Come out and support the underground, man. Without the fans, there is no underground.
That's true.
You can go pay tons of money to see Metallica, but they don't play like they used to. It's more commercial metal now.
That's true.
If you want to even call it metal. Anyway, support the underground, you know?
Thank you so much.
Thank you too, man. Nice interview.
Malta. Thank you. Pac-Man Underground's voice. Mantenham-se atentos. Nós voltamos em breve.
See you tonight. I hope you're here.